We're here speaking to National Under 20 Women's Team Manager Maylee Attin-Johnson. Maylee, I can see the look of not just relief but satisfaction on your face. The fact that you guys went to Dominican Republic, reached the quarterfinals, went beyond the first round. And how do you feel about this?
I think I'm super proud of the young ladies. I think where we may have lacked in talent, they more than made up for it in hard work, the grit and determination. And I can't thank them enough for the hard work and sacrifices that they made to just represent our country. And I'm super proud of them, and I look forward to working with them in the future.
We know that there were challenges that this team faced because of the short space of time before the tournament. But how much of a difference did the training camp, you think, make to the efforts?
I mean, it certainly did. I think we went there, what, 10 days before the tournament itself. It helped, but it just shows how far we are behind the top teams in CONCACAF. It is imperative of the heads that be to watch out women's football and invest heavily in it. I think, as I told the technical chairman, the fastest way to our World Cup is through the women's game. And I truly believe once they invest heavily in the women's game, we have a great opportunity to qualify for a women's World Cup in any age group.
Not too long ago, you were in their position. What about this team made you give you a sense of belief and hope that we're heading in the right direction?
No, you know, for me, it's about progressing the women's game. And I think when I got the opportunity to do so, I took it up. I think with these young ladies, they came a long, long, long way from being at least seven of those players played in 2015, I believe, where they lost over 20-something nil to the U.S. And they've come a long way. And I think for me, being in their position in playing youth football, I think it was imperative that I came and give back and just share my knowledge and help motivate them and let them know that there's so many things that could come out of representing a country, where we got a lot of calls for the young ladies to go to school. So that was a great opportunity for me always to help serve and represent my country.
Great, thanks a lot, Maylee. So we're speaking here with team captain Afiyah Cornwall. Afiyah, I can see the smiles on your face. Going into this tournament, did you believe that you would have put out sort of performance and that the team would get to the quarterfinals?
Yeah, I have full support from my team and myself. And I'm confident in my team, and I have to step up to the table and take the captain responsibility and do the job.
What was it like being out there with your teammates? Every game was a different challenge, starting from the first game, but again, starting from the opening match of the campaign, which was the training game. Go through the journey with us.
Well, the first game was kind of rough. We didn't adapt to the atmosphere, but after we adapted and we get ourselves together and gain the wins. But playing with new players is an extremely new experience, and I like it.
The training camp, how helpful do you think that was?
I think that was a good help, that we improved on better stuff and we played together for like 2 weeks, but we didn't get enough work in, but we still try our best.
The Mexico game, obviously that was the toughest of the challenges, and it shows that, you know, we have some work to do, but how you felt based on the progress that we showed over the tournament, how optimistic are you about our football going forward in the women's game?
I think we did well, because in a short space of time, we get a lot in. Like, teams training for years, we only train for like 2 months. And I think in a little bit of space, we did real well. And I just hope that Trinidad and Tobago lift women's football.
What's next for your Cornwall?
Next World Cup, we'll reach there.
Thanks a lot and good luck. All right, so we're here speaking to Women's Under 20 head coach Richard Hood. Coach, you're back home, you know, coming back from a competition where the goal was to get out of the first round, get to the quarterfinals. You achieved that. Didn't end up the best of note, but still a lot to be proud of.
Absolutely. I think the girls came a long way in a very short time. and we couldn't ask more of them. All right, we showed a lot of improvement as we went along, and that game against Mexico, I would say that they gave it their all, but they didn't have anything left in them. Yeah. So I'm very proud of the performances out there. I'm very proud of the girls. I told them as much, and I think it you know, it's for us now to do the right things going forward to ensure that we have a future in women's football.
When you look at the composition of your squad, half your team you met there in Dominican Republic, you had 2 months to prepare this team and yet you were able to get something out of them. It shows that with proper planning and proper implementation that we can reach places. How important was this training camp towards the efforts?
The training camp itself was critical. One of the things that we encountered when we got there, the first game we played was 2 days after we got there, and the girls were they were struggling to breathe. You know, there was a bit of acclimatization situation there. So had we not had the camp and gone into that situation, into the tournament without that acclimatizing, we would have really struggled big time. Also, there was that opportunity for us to get the team to get together to form that nice unit that eventually we found happened. So the camp itself was critical to the success of the team.
Generally, how would you sum up this experience for the women's under 20 team?
I'd say it's a good learning experience for the players, certainly for the staff as well. I'd hope it's a good learning experience for the TTFA and Trinidad and Tobago in general. We have potential, right? We just need to do the right thing to harness the potential, right? We need to have these girls training consistently on a consistent basis. This cycle is over. There's another two years before the next under 20 tournament, and let us prepare well for that tournament. All right, let us not wait a couple of months before and then try to hurriedly get a team together. All right, we need to keep the girls together and keep them working towards this. A number of these girls who play this tournament are eligible for the next tournament, so there is a base, right? We can work. We have a base to work with. All right, let's do the job.
Do you see some potential from this squad that could enter into the senior women's team?
Absolutely. Cornwall is definitely a senior. At the moment, I think she's a senior women's player. I think Sarah DeGans as well. Alexi Ali has shown a lot of potential. She just needs to get stronger. I would also say I was pleasantly surprised with the work of Cyan Fernandez as well. She did really well out there. So there is a lot of potential in the team. Again, just to get the right things done so that we can harness that potential.
Next up for you, women's under 17, so there's no rest for the wicked, right?
Yeah. Our tournament starts on the 18th of April. I'm actually going to take a couple of days to recover a little bit and then start back to work with them on Monday. That's my intention. A lot of work to be done, all right? And the majority of this team has not played any international football, has not played any football at any great level. Fortunately, we had 3 players on this team, Latifa Pascal, Moisha Meyas, and Rushon Williams. Those 3 are eligible for the under 17, so they will be with them after a little break as well. They will take a little break and come back with them. So they have some experience. We have some decent players in Tobago as well that we are hopeful that will be joining the team on a regular basis. And I understand that the TIPS program has unearthed about 8 players in North America as well. So it will be a challenge. We have a lot of work to do, but we look forward to the challenge.
And you also have a training camp to look forward to ahead of this tournament?
I understand that is in place, similarly to what we did with the Dominican Republic. So, yeah, you know, I thank the TTFA for that, because, again, it is absolutely, it will be needed.
Coach, thanks a lot and good luck. Yeah, thanks. Yeah.